pretty good student.
Who sat in a pretty good class.
And was taught by a pretty good teacher.
Who always let pretty good pass.
He wasn't terrific at reading.
He wasn't
a whiz bang
at math.
But for him, education was leading.
Straight down a pretty good path.
He didn't find school too exciting.
But he wanted to do pretty well.
And he did have some trouble with writing.
And nobody taught him to spell.
When doing arithmetic problems,
pretty good was regarded as fine.
5 + 5 didn't always add to 10.
A pretty good answer was 9. A pretty good class that he sat in
was part of a pretty good school.
And the student was not the exception.
On the contrary, he was the rule.
The pretty good school that he went to
was there in a pretty good town.
And nobody there seemed to notice.
He couldn't tell a verb from a noun.
The pretty good student, in fact, was
part of a pretty good mob.
And the first time he knew what he lacked was
when he looked for a pretty good job.
It was then when he sought a position.
He discovered that life could be tough.
And he soon had a sneaky suspicion. Pretty good might not be good enough. The pretty good town in our story was part of a pretty good state, which had pretty good aspirations
and prayed for a pretty good fate.
There once was a pretty good nation,
pretty proud of the greatness it had,
which learned much too late if he wanted to